It has been said, and it's all over. We all know. Gayton McKenzie said that Makhadzi should not behave like they did not benefit. Hey, Makhadzi was like, you know what? You guys have been doing this, walking over my head, thinking that I'm going to keep quiet. She responded. Now, a long list of people who benefited from, from the government, their lists are all over, right? We're going to speak about that. And, you know, I saw a very interesting comment by somebody who said, okay, we see this list, but does this mean that these people benefited unduly just because they were local, the government paid towards them? And somebody says, there's a wrong narrative that is being painted here, right? But there's another interesting story as well, speaking about people that benefited from this government shenanigans and. The name of Uata Mafukate keeps coming back and just keeps coming back, right? You know, you know, it speaks about Uata Mafukate, Aboba Tusile, some of the artists that got paid the grant during COVID-19. Well, the name that probably will catch your attention is the name of Uata Mafukate, because the problem with him is that he just keep getting these government deals or funding, whatever you know how to name it. But so we're gonna be talking about the story of Makhadzi responding to Gayton McKenzie as a Minister of Sport, Arts and Culture, and say, listen, do not think that just by the mere fact of me maybe participating in government activities, now you might think that me going to America, the government assisted me. No, I needed your support, guys, but you did not show up. In an article written by IOL, it says Makhadzi versus Gayton McKenzie, the department paid over 2,300,000 in the past year for gigs, right? Award-winning singer Makhadzi, who recently opened up about a lack of support from government for her recent trip to U.S., begged over 230,000 performance fee from the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture in the past 14 months. All right. And I love what Makhadzi says. Makhadzi did not say that she did not have even a single cent. But she said, at this moment, I don't have money because of SARS. Right. And the government did not intervene, Gayton McKenzie involved. But before we proceed with everything here, why don't you do this? If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment, so the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
So Gayton McKenzie had said this has been revealed by the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture after its minister Gayton McKenzie ordered artists and sports stars and creative who received funding from the department to be named publicly with the reasons and the amount thereof. Right. They said that the DSAC strongly rejects the assertion that it has not supported Makhadzi over the past 14 months. Makhadzi has been booked by the DCSC to perform in several national engagements, receiving as much as 230,000 rand. Right, and then they go on get to in their media statement. Makhadzi did not take that kindly, and Makhadzi was like, listen, I'm not going to take that kindly, but listen to this one. The whole country is waiting for people who are eating money to be revealed, and they are failing, and they are starting with me, and I never ate a cent. Oh, that is Makhadzi. I at this moment, I think when she spoke about eating money, I think she's referring to people who unduly benefited from government. I will think so, right? She said, they feel I'm quiet and I can't speak for myself. They are taking advantage of me. They have to use me as an example. I can't allow that, says Makhadzi. Makhadzi continues, I didn't eat any money. They must reveal the people that ate the money for the department. They must reveal the real names of the people that were funded unlawfully. Oh, yes. You see, here, that's why she explained it very nicely when she says people who were funded unlawfully. Because I feel like right now, the narrative, if it's not explained, it's going to create problems. Look, I think we must, look, when you say people benefited from government, we must specify what we are talking about. You know, we shouldn't just talk about things, G, you know what I'm saying, loosely, because we are creating a wrong narrative. Makhadzi continues to say, I've been doing a lot of things that need funding, and no one has been funding me, and I was okay with that. I never said anything. I don't want free money. I don't want free money. I'm just telling the truth. Oza Makhadzi. Uthi Makhadzi, no, mina ongaze ngathi ngifuna imali zamahala. Hayi mina ngancane. Hayi mina ngancane. So speaking about imali zamahala, free money. What do you make of uAta Mafukate being remember that there was this story of unduly benefiting from Lotto and whatever that was funded for. They actually did not do what they were they received that money for, right? So the long list here, I'm still gonna try maybe to find it, because it's a very 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 long list of people. I see the names. I've got it here, but I do not want to lie to you. It's a very, very long list. So I wouldn't even dare going through the list. But also, I'm afraid that if we stand a chance of painting a very dangerous narrative, a narrative that will seek to say, just because you are on the list, therefore, you benefited unduly. That's why I said that, yeah, look, on my other video yesterday, you see, when Gayton McKenzie speaks, he's creating a hype, and there's this hype that is happening. The problem with whatever he says, he doesn't explain things. He just said things in one, two sentences and leave it there so that people can now say things. That's what I'm saying. It's very dangerous. You know, when he says, I'm going to make spinning a big thing in South Africa. And then the next thing, we see him withdrawing support of soccer. You know, looking at all these things, it just paints a bad narrative. We must be careful not to see McKenzie now pushing more towards rugby, pushing more towards spinning cars. Forgetting that rugby is well-funded. We must be careful of that. So even now, with the names of people that have been benefiting from government, the way it comes out, it doesn't come out in the right way. It's not in the right way, man. There's something wrong with how this thing is being said. At least if there was an explanation to say, these are the people that were once hired by the department, and these are the people who benefited from us hiring them because that's what musicians live for. They, you know, we saw it during election campaigns.
you will see an artist being booked by the ANC, by EFF, by a local, by MK Party, same artist. And we don't complain because artists are there to perform and make money out of their performance. And that's the whole essence of being a creative, is that you must use your skill, you must use your God-given skill to, like, and then you get paid for using your God-given skill. That's the whole point of it anyway. So if you've got Gaten Makenza that doesn't explain when he says people who benefited from government, but he doesn't explain how, right? Because now a lot of people will think that, ah, man, it's unlawful. People benefited unlawful. Yes, we do know, like, for instance, Abo Atama Fokate, who we say it boldly because they have already appeared before courts, right? And their assets has been seized. So we say it boldly that we know that there are things that were done wrong, right? But it doesn't mean that every artist that benefited from government or was funded by government is therefore must be painted in a negative way. No, guys. It's like, guys, the other, look, one day we will be saying, everybody who wants to receive a tender from government, come on. No, we must distinguish. We must say, Saudi, hey, you got a tender of under delivering after getting money. Let's follow up how many people in that category. But there are people generally who get tenders from government and they deliver quality service, right? We shouldn't just think that just because a person is a tenderpreneur, now those people are delivering bad quality just because we see this bad quality that we are seeing out there. No. It's very dangerous. Look, because there's a thin line. We must be able to draw a line and explain things thoroughly so that we don't create a perception and a narrative that when we will be asked, and then we'll be able to say, we are creating a leeway. Once we create a narrative and a perspective, and then we don't explain things thoroughly, people will be, we know that we are playing into people's heads, right? People will then think, oh, there was a corruption and all the stuff. But when we will be asked, and then we'll be like, oh, you know, we never said there's a corruption. But already, other people would have been painted in a negative way. So when we approach it, it's always important to approach it from that perspective that you are talking about creatives here whose image matters. You are talking about artists, all those creatives that are involved. Their image matters because their image is their bread. I wish Gaten Makenzi, as he enters the office, as he's trending, whatever he's doing, I wish that that energy should be channeled. I wish that he channels that energy in the right way, in a manner that at the end of the day, he doesn't create problems for others. You understand? We've been suspecting people for criminal activities. We don't trust ANC. You know what I'm saying? So we don't want to associate the corruption there on with the ANC. You know, no. I will speak for artists on this one. We look, there must be distinction of people who were funded by government to perform. They benefited duly, and then there are those who benefited unlawfully. We must distinguish the list and say, these are the list of people who benefited duly, and these ones did not deliver. Like my cat is saying, no, she's like, no, man, I'm not out there looking for free money. So don't think that I am out there looking for money. No, I'm not looking for free money. All I'm saying is, hire me, I'll come and perform. Whether you are Department of Correctional Service, Police, Arts and Culture, I don't care. As long as the person who's hiring me, or the Department of Department of Water and Sanitation, Home Affairs, they are saying, we don't care. All we care about is this one. That is my card. She's like, no, all I care about is that you book me, you get charged booking fees, and you pay for that. I come and perform, you pay for my performance. Ah, the rest, I don't care. In that way, Makat, she's like, no, if you ask me to perform, you pay the money, I perform. Take me to court. I benefited fairly. That's what Makat is looking for. And you can't fault her, Makat. In that way, I can only say, big up, Makat. You know, that's what we'll also expect from people who are tenderpreneurs. When you receive a tender, deliver. and then go eat the profit. We're not fighting. We're just saying, when you are told, build this road from here to there, deliver. When you're done delivering, then you can go eat the profit. Nobody's going to accuse you. We take you to court. Oh, you know, that's what Makati is fighting for.